What's up, guys? It is Jay Beebs here, and welcome to another episode of the All Quarterback Fantasy Draft. This is probably our biggest episode yet, because if we are able to win this game, or the Bengals lose, we will have clinched the division. And we are also, we should be able to clinch the number one seed as well, I believe, with this win. No, we cannot. Actually, we might be able to. So we could potentially clinch the number one seed and clinch the division as long as we beat the 6-8 Colts. We should, in my opinion, we should be able to get this done. However, I mean, this is the NFL. So for those of you who don't know how the series works, basically in the first episode of the series, I went and I did a fantasy draft where I selected 53 quarterbacks. Then I went into franchise mode and edited their positions in order to make them fit the team. So Ben Roethlisberger is at kicker. Russell Wilson is at corner. Tyrod Taylor is at corner. Tom Brady is our quarterback. But we got Matt Ryan at center. So I just, you went through, did that. And we actually have a pretty decent team. And we're currently 12-2 in the regular season. Yeah, I mean, Taysom Hill is at strong safety. I'm actually very excited to see how far we can go with this team. Alright, so Ben Roethlisberger is going to get us underway here. Alright, good tackle there. They're going to start on their 31. Correct. Looks like it's Derek Carr. Oh, it's Nick Mullins. Okay, he is not the greatest. Starting off, but I don't know how. I mean, he's got really good numbers so far this season, so I don't know where he's at. Alright, one thing you may have noticed is that this is a different playbook than what I've been normally using. It's because I didn't really like the lack of. Well, yeah, I just wanted to make a new one, really. Didn't really like the old one. So I went through and I made a new one. I actually really like this playbook, both offensively and defensively. Okay, so we're going to have to try this cover four drop. For those of you new to this series, defense is a huge struggle. Because, we do not have good pass rushers, because they are NFL quarterbacks. So usually, we don't usually get much pressure on the quarterback, which is an issue. Because at the same time, our secondary isn't good enough to allow the quarterback to have that much time. So it's a really tough decision for this team. And this will probably be one of the very few times I actually call man coverage during this game. Because, again, I mean, you got Russell Wilson in coverage. Don't necessarily want him being man-to-man. That's a good tackle there by Cam Newton. You know, Cam Newton, the middle linebacker. Also got Drew Brees, the corner. Trace McSorley and Jalen Hurts, the outside linebackers. Yep. All right, we're gonna try to bring a little bit. Actually, no, we won't bring heat. We'll just drop off. We'll even guess pass. All right, hopefully now we're starting to get into the territory where we should looking to get a nice turnover. Hopefully I can use Brissett to make the center mark on to me. Alright. And it was only a 3-yard run. Easily could have been more, but thankfully it wasn't. Alright, let's see what we can do here with Jalen Hurts working against the left tackle. It's kind of annoying playing defense with this team. Because, I mean, especially, I mean, we get no pressure on the quarterback. And essentially, I mean, that's all they have to do to score a touchdown. It's okay, because this team realistically does its best in really 4 minutes and under in the half, in the first and second half. Because that's really where, I mean, they're put in a passing situation. That's where we tend to sell a little bit. We're in a passing situation. That's where our offense really starts to pick up. And we're just going to fair catch it there with Flowers. And the GOAT, probably, arguably the legend himself, Tom Brady, stepping onto the field. They may think his numbers look pretty low for this being week 16 of the NFL season. Well, that's because we were using Russell Wilson for a good majority of the season. Then we used Drew Brees for a couple of games. I think Brady's only played 5 or 6 games. All right, we're going to start here with a little bit of a shotgun run with Mariota. That was a brilliant block. Absolutely perfect. Did a really good job of making Mariota move out of his way. Alright, we're going to try this corner strike play. Hopefully this is a cover 2 and we can hit Stevens on that little... There we go. Tommy Stevens, if you're new to the series, he is definitely the most surprising player on this team. I think saying anyone else would be completely false. He was a beast for us in the preseason. And a beast for us so far this season. Etling, our second receiver, he's been a very solid number 2. I prove he's actually been a solid number 2. We're going to look him on this little stick and nod route. Yeah, Tommy Stevens last week, on the season, we can actually get him 2,000 receiving yards. Could Tommy Stevens set this single season receiving record? Oh, Tommy, I was just talking so much praise about you and how good you were. I even possession caught that. I don't know why that happened. That just gives us an opportunity to throw it to our tight end, Perkins, who has also been a surprising standout this season. I don't know what it is, but for some reason, Perkins has been an absolutely fantastic player for us this year. So I actually think they're blitzing here. Yep. I think we should be able to hit Perkins. Alright, now we're... Yeah, look at that. Our tight end has over 1,000 receiving yards. Alright, so that's going to take us to the second quarter. Ball in the 2. We're going to look to do a shotgun run, because hopefully they spread out their defense. Yep. And Mariota should be able to sneak in between the center and left guard. Yep. And just like that, all tied up. Alright, Big Ben's on to kick it here. Kick is up, and it is good. So, really, really good start to the game for this team. I don't think you can really deny that. I mean, 7-7. And we know that as far as time goes, I mean, obviously, we can march down the field whenever we want. And that's really been the story of the season is... Offense has played well. Defense and special teams coverage and defense has just not been able to do anything. But you know, I mean, you gotta kind of expect that when you're doing this. I mean, you got Terry McSorley and Jalen Hurts as outside rushers. you kind of got to expect. You got to kind of expect your defense to get trampled over. It's okay, because, I mean, there has been times where our defense has done a very good job. However, there also has been times where our defense has done poorly. Like, look at that. Grayson McSorley got a good... did a good job of getting past his blocker there. But because there was no, literally no other pressure, Mullins had time to set his feet and at least attempt to throw that ball away. And most of the time, our tackles end up just kind of bouncing off. Surprisingly, we have forced, I think, 2 fumbles so far this season. I don't know how, but we did. Okay, that was the first time I've ever seen that animation.
He's tackled at the 29-yard line. A gain of 12. And a Colts first down.
All right, let's see if we can get some Minshew magic here on the pass rush. Oh, we did. Oh.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Mullins pass complete to number 19.
I'm so bad at switching on to corners.
Touchdown, Indianapolis.
I think my problem is I switched on too early.
Dustin Hopkins on for the extra point.
So, I mean, I can never tell with the camera angles where the ball is actually going to end up going. Oh, and Trace McSorley just got hurt. Alright, let's give offense a chance to get out in the field. See what they can do. Yeah, we'll return this one. Why not? You never know what can happen. And we got a yard. Not that bad. There's actually a bruised elbow. Alright, that doesn't seem that long. That bad. Another thing is, I mean, this point in the season, we're not... if someone gets hurt, I'm definitely erring on the safe side. I mean, we are 12-2. We've clinched playoffs. But, I mean, right now, we're really just looking to clinch division. And get the one seed. Next week, if we win this game and we can clinch the one seed, I don't think Tom Brady's gonna be playing. I think I'll probably play just about everyone else. But I just don't want to risk anything. Alright, we're gonna look at Perkins on this play action play here. Oh, Tyree. Tried to hit fullback. I'm going to look Stevens underneath here, probably. I want to hit Etling, but I don't know. Yeah. And Stevens is just a better player. Is that 3rd and 4? Yep. 3rd and 4, yep. We will spread things out a little bit. And we'll just run slants. Now, if you look at our receiver furthest to the right, Strubler, wearing number 1. Well, that's because he's actually our 3rd-string QB. However, he is our 4th best wide receiver. So, good day. Why not? This team's already doing something pretty interesting. I mean, I'll make it quite interesting to see, you know. I mean, we got a quarterback, a wide receiver, and we got a quarterback, a running back. And since we have a quarterback, a running back, I've been looking to run this play. The halfback pass. Normally, this is a terrible decision, doesn't work out. But when you have a terrible offensive line, you can also expect it to not work at all. Alright, well, we'll save that one for a different time, I guess. I don't think Flowers is going to get open. I don't think it's a true cover 2. And of course, our offensive line can't hold up for more than 2 seconds. Alright, we're going to look. gonna look Stevens to catch, to run after he catches it. So now we're gonna hit Perkins. Alright. Doing a good job of not only clock management, but just going down the field. I mean, that was really, it's our first play I didn't think would, I didn't know if it would exactly work out 100%. Marcus Mariota carries the ball to the one. Goal line. Put Big Ben in at QB. And we'll look to just QB sneak it. There we go. You mean he's still a quarterback. He's technically our kicker. However, you know, he's still a quarterback. So Big Ben scores the touchdown and kicks the extra point. I would love for some NFL stat on when was the last time a player did that. It's the last time that a player physically scored the touchdown. Not throwing, but physically scored the touchdown. And then kicked the extra point afterwards. Another thing you saw on that kick coverage there, that was almost really, really bad. Yeah, that's where, that's what kick coverage likes to do. Alright, now it's pretty much a passing situation. So if we can get Hurts to take advantage of this left tackle. Alright, good hit there by Mitch Trubisky. That's right, Mitch Trubisky at corner. So they're probably going to end up getting a field goal out of this, unless we can somehow pick them off. Because, I mean, they're marching down the field pretty well right now. I am a little bit concerned about Bullen's running. So I'll probably just switch us to a cover two here. Go on Jacoby Brissett, see if we can work on Rodney Hudson. There we go, Jacoby. I think we're going to stick with this cover two play. Because I wasn't watching what the coverage was like downfield. There we go. No, best part about... Okay, so they've conceded, essentially. And we'll switch to more of a blitz play then. And we'll call the timeout here. So I believe that's fourth, and they're only at 37. That's a 54-yard field goal. You can go ahead and try that. 54 yards with Hopkins. I don't know if he really could make it, but I don't know if he will. That was short. Let's go. So here we got two timeouts. To go, essentially, we got two timeouts to get the team down the field and score. Realistically. Alright. Again, we're just looking to get out of bounds quickly here, so we're probably going to end up in Perkins underneath. Nope. Look, Stevens to get the catch. No huddle. Extra drag. Brings up second and a yard. Alright, gotta call a timeout here. Alright, 14 seconds, we're on the 40. We still need a lot of yards if we're gonna kick it. Because obviously Big Ben, he's not a real kicker, so he needs a lot of space. So we're gonna look to hit Stevens here. Actually, no, we're just gonna dump it off at Flowers. Did he get out? No, he didn't. Alright, we're on the 26. We'll try that play again. Because, I mean, realistically, we'll probably just roll out and throw it away. No! He went out, right? Flowers, you idiot! So He's an absolute idiot. Why did he turn like that? Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. The weather might be cold. We could literally be up a field goal right now. He couldn't get out of bounds in time. Alright, well, he has to make up for it at some point during this game. That is inexcusable. It wasn't that complex of instructions of what we needed to do. It was pretty basic. Alright, we'll just dump it off of Paxton Lynch there for some yards. I'm actually mad at Flowers right now. Oh, he's made a block in the back. I thought really that was just up there. But what a run by Mariota, though.
Oh, no!
Tommy, come on. I don't pay you money to block, so don't. I want to hit Stevens. But yeah, I wasn't open. So let's hit Etling. I guess it's a couple of yards. A yard. Alright. Little gun wing pair. Kind of drive. Alright, good catch there by Paxton Lynch. That should activate Tom Brady's X-Factor. What? Oh, that last pass wasn't firm enough yards. Or the one before this block, the most recent play. Oh well. Alright, that's 3 yards. Take it. Let's try for a bigger play. I mean, this is essentially just the same exact play. It's 3rd and 1. If I'm not mistaken. Yep, 3rd and 1. Alright. The reason why Strebler is not in at wide receiver full time is because he is an extremely athletic quarterback. So, if we want to run a nice QB power with him, pick up just a simple yard, we can. Alright. But this play, really reading that left middle linebacker to see what he ends up doing. So he goes in coverage, so that means Steven should get wide open. But for some reason he didn't catch the ball. I'm not going to run the read option with Tom Brady. As hilarious as that would be. We're going to look Flowers underneath so we can run after a catch. Well, in order to run after the catch, you actually have to make the catch. Alright, hopefully, with this, I think actually that left middle linebacker is in main coverage on Tommy Stevens. Oh, it was a zone. And Flowers drops it again. I'm gonna have issues with Flowers. I might have to move a Strebler to third string wide receiver. I mean, Flowers is really, he's normally our fourth receiver, but he's only playing because RG3 is normally our third receiver. I think he got hurt. I think he's supposed to be back for the playoffs. I'm not 100% sure. But I do know we miss him. Because all those Flowers fails. I mean, RG3 would have been doing all those, making all those mistakes. Alright, this puts us in a bad position. Every time they've gotten the ball, they've scored. I mean, we can't even tackle and bring down James White. That says anything about this team's tackling ability. James White was running over people. Good tackle there by Tyrod. Third and three. We're going to bring some heat. And they're playing terror. There we go. Have Tracy Shirley with the tackle. Okay, Tracy Shirley. We see you. We see you. Alright, Kern's gonna punt it away to Taysom Hill. Okay, he actually got a block that time. He actually did pretty well with it there. Alright, we're just gonna run the ball here to start on first down. The run actually has been working decently well. Now, I think I don't want to, because obviously with this team we don't want to get into a battle at the line of scrimmage. It is nice to have a 3rd and 4, not have to throw it every single time. We're trying to ISO. Who's he under? Hopefully Etling can split the safeties here. Pocket to hold up for another second, and that way Etling can get a nice touchdown. And just like that, it's a 2-possession lead. It's amazing what happens when the pocket can hold up for more than 3 seconds. It's a crazy thing. I know our offensive line's never heard of it, but it's just a crazy thing that when we can stop the blitz or pressure for like 3 seconds, he can score a touchdown. Now realistically, you want this next drive of theirs to take as long as possible. Thank you. Yeah, we'll go a nice 4-3. 4-3, cover 1, QB contain. The Joe Webb tackle? Or that was Jalen Hurts. Alright, we'll try this nickel look here. Honestly, we have pretty decent linebackers. Nice big hit there, Teddy. Teddy Bridgewater's a free safety. That was his full speed hit stick tackle on James White. I honestly don't think I would be minding the running back running over us like this if it wasn't James White. Alright, 2nd and 2. Again, taking up a lot of time. We're time managing at this point in the game. Good job there, Cam Newton. Did a good job of reading the play the entire time. guessing pass. I'm assuming they're going to pass. Alright. And they're driving down the field, but I mean.
There's no point trying to stop it.
This game's putting me to sleep. Aww. Yep. Okay. Okay. I mean, it was a cover two. Ran a good route there. If anything, this means our offense has to make sure that they keep playing well. I mean, we have drove down the field every time we've gotten the ball. It's a completely different animal. Just late in the game. 26. Yep. Every yard matters at this point. Our own, put chew clock on here. Really want to give Etling get his fifth receiving touchdown? Alright, maybe it'll happen, maybe it won't. Either way, Marcus Mariota is playing very well this game. I mean, yeah, 5.8 yard average. Pretty nice deep bomb. You gotta keep the defense honest here. Honestly, Perkins might be able to bust this route wide open. They're blitzing. I think it's going to get rough in the passer. Oh. Holding, really? Right tackle? Keenum? But why did you hold? I mean, we just got a first down. You just negated literally all that.
Oh well, disappointing.
We just got a bunch of those yards back with Perkins. Still be nice to have a touchdown though. Or a first down. I'd love a touchdown. Now we're going to try Mariota on the draw here. Because obviously they're expecting us to pass. He's been pass heavy. And that takes more time off the clock. So, you know, that Flowers' inability to get out of bounds before the half right now is killing us. Because, I mean, if he got out of bounds, we could just play a kick and extra field goal here. But now we got to really clock manage. Alright, a couple yards there. Taking time off the clock. We'll run it up the gut with Mariota to take us into the 2-minute warning. Let the play clock and game clock wind down a little bit. Excuse me, first or third? Third. Yeah, I think we're just going to go to halfback slam play again.
Probably could call a little bit of trickery, but
don't really need to. Don't even need to think about it. Now we're in full kill clock mode. Me and Mariota ran for the first. They gotta call a timeout. Now we just gotta. We gotta try to get the first. But most importantly, we gotta run the ball and stay in bounds. Alright, that should have just sealed the game. Marcus Mariota. Probably best game of the season. To reward him, you're going to keep feeding him. Brady flipped the run. Alright, Game over. Game over. Marcus Mariota, have yourself a game. So imperative that Mariota plays well. Because when we're trying to kill the clock, if he's able to run as well as he was just there, no doubt in my mind we're going to have, no doubt in my mind we're going to be able to run the clock down to zeros. Whoa, not, nope, not going to onside it. So with this, oh, I haven't been looking for the score. I don't know what the Bengals score is. Ravens are tied. Bengals are losing, but they're coming back. We've all but won this game. There you go. Thanks for getting Russell Wilson a little bit of XP for making the tackle. There you go. Get Cam Newton a little bit of XP. Inbounds, right? Oh, they give him out of bounds? Really? I don't know if he's out of bounds there. What are they doing? They're trying to do a little bit of trickery. Good tackle by Trubisky. Inbounds, correct? Yep. Alright, we'll go cover T drop. We'll get that QB spy out there. Russell Wilson with the tackle. The game's over at this point. I mean, actually, they're probably trying, because they're probably trying for a playoff spot. Yeah. So it looks like we're going to end up winning this game by a field goal for probably the 10th game this season. Because for some reason, Ben Roethlisberger has been the deciding factor in most of our games. If we don't recover this, I think I might break my controller. Thank you, Strubler. See? All-around athlete. Now, we can just kneel it out. We're not putting Tom Brady. We'll put Matt Barkley back there. His rushing yards are irrelevant. Why does the CPU always call a timeout there? Like, we're kneeling the clock out to end the game. That's the entire point of kneeling the ball. To end the game. Which we have successfully done. So that now puts us at 13-2. That was a very good game by the team. Huge game, as I'm pretty sure we just... Actually, no, I don't remember. I know we clinched our division. I don't know if we clinched the one seed that yet, though. Have to check that out after the game. Oh, you still got those stats. We definitely deserve to win. Hopefully we can get Brady another Lombardi, another Super Bowl ring, get the Steelers another Lombardi trophy. Hopefully. Still have the playoffs to go through, though. And that's what concerns me, because there's a chance we play a bad game. And if this team plays a bad game, you know it's bad. Alright, so there's all the broken 12 overall players. Tommy Stevens, another upgrade. Don't mind if I do. Yep, just keep getting that physical up. Pretty obvious that's what you've kind of turned into. just that big, big wide receiver. Get Easton Stick, increases receiving back. Etling with an upgrade. Yep, he's a little bit more of a deep threat as far as the passing game goes. Jalen Hurts with an upgrade. Yep, get that speed rusher up. Pretty sure it should be player rack and speed. Finesse moves tackle. Cole McDonald, one of our corners. I think he's our third or fourth corner, but he ends up playing a lot on dime. Taylor Heinicke made himself a name in the playoffs. But obviously I started this before all this happened, so that is not his 60 overall card. I think it's his 51. Yep, and tell it to auto upgrade all the broken players. Yep. Alright, now let's take a look at these standings. Oh, Bengals lost. Alright, so it's only the X because the Broncos won their game. I believe. So now, week 17 actually matters. I believe. Oh no, it doesn't. We have clinched. Broncos lost. So we are the one seed. We're the guaranteed one seed. Oh, I don't want to end up facing the Bengals. I think the Bengals might actually beat the Broncos. The Bengals are a very good team. But we don't have to worry about that for 3 weeks because we got the bye. And we got this week 17 game against the Browns, and it doesn't really matter for our team. So, if you enjoyed this episode, leave a like, subscribe, because at this point, you got to see how the rest of the series ends up working out. So, make sure you do that, and it is Jay Beebs, signing off.